21. I was 15 shopping for them chains, but early as a gin and diaper, some shit happened. Ladies and gentlemen, classical family, it's your boy GIDI back with another reaction. Hope you guys are doing good. I'm doing great. I got my tea, so I can't complain. But today we are reacting to a piece by Sibelius, 1894, The Wood Nymph. The Wood Nymph. So it's, I see the artist, Timo Kainunen, with the Lahti Symphony Orchestra, and I don't know which one of them is the conductor, but here it says Osmo Vanska. So yeah, looking forward to it. Let me Google right quick what the Wood Nymph stands for. So the Wood Nymph is a folklore in Sweden, and it says it's a mythical female creature of the forest in Swedish. It appears in the form of a small, beautiful woman with a seemingly friendly temperament. She appears like a woman from the front, but seen from behind, she often has a tail and a hollow back of skin like a tree bark. Bro, this already sounds scary. Those who are enticed into following her into the forest are never seen again. I'll be telling y'all, bro, these men be thirsty. Don't be chasing after these women, bro. Don't do that. It was said that any human man who had intercourse with the Skorskra or the Wood Nymph became an introvert. I feel attacked. As his soul had remained with her. If the seduced man is a hunter, he may be rewarded with good luck in the hunt. But should he be unfaithful to the Skorskra, he will be punished with numerous accidents. He may put an end to a stormy night caused by her vengeance by firing a shot against her. Oh, okay, silver bullets. Like, you know, using that against a werewolf. What's effective? Of killing the wood nymph, but interesting folklore. I feel like we have a little bit of insight towards or of this piece, so yeah, let's go. Oh, it's already starting. Pretty crazy.
Thank you.
It sounds like a movie in my head. And I like the piece. It's really fitting.
Thank you.
Listening to this piece and having that story in the back of my head, I was just trying to like picture everything that's going on. So obviously, as I said in the beginning, it's about this hunter named Björn, and he goes into the forest to hunt. And the whole piece, it's just basically following how he sees this wood nymph and gets seduced by it, and then he's cursed and then falls into a deep depression. So I had the story over here because the member that requested this piece, obviously, he also put in the story for me, also with the timestamps. I'll put it down in the description. But just listening to the progression or the build up of the piece, you know, from the beginning to the end, especially that ending. You know, it says he falls into a deep depression. I don't know if something comes after that, but that ending was loud, very loud, and very strong. Normally, when there's no happy ending at the end of a story, I mean, I would expect the piece to, you know, not end loud, but rather end really slow and just sound a bit more sad. But this one was really loud and it sounded really aggressive too, and just a very strong ending. So I was kind of caught off guard there, but I loved the ending, especially the ending. But yeah, very interesting. I think Sibelius, for some reason, I always think he's a French composer, but I think Sibelius was from Finland. I think he was from Finland. If I'm wrong, please correct me down in the comments. But yeah, hey, shout out to the member that requested this. It's always nice to have, you know, a piece that has like a poem or like a story attached to it. Yeah, with this one being a folklore from Sweden, it makes it very interesting. But yeah, let me know down in the comments, like, do y'all know about this piece, and do you know about this story or folklore? What do you think about it? Did you enjoy it? Did you not like it? You know, respectful opinions, obviously. But classical fam, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. It's been your boy GIDI. I'm gonna catch you on the next video.